Hello, ladies, and welcome back to Still Looking Good 58, the channel that reviews wigs for the mature woman. Today, I'm going to give you not just an update on this HD Ultra Scalp Illusion wig carry, but we're going to do a little bit of a deep dive. Now, when I first did this video of this review of this wig, I told you guys that I was going to keep the faux scalp because it matched my skin, and it did. But the closer I looked at this wig, the second time I put it on, that line of demarcation was driving me crazy. Even though it was slight, it was still enough to make me feel like I needed to take it out. So what I'm going to explain to you and show you a little bit of video of is how you need to take it out. And the key to taking it out is this little tool right here. I want you to get a good look at this. I'm going to wait till this thing comes into focus, because this is called a ripper. And this is a sewing tool. And this ripper is very important when it comes to taking that scalp out of there. And let me just show you some video of that so that you can see. And I'm going to explain it in the video. I'm trying to show this to you. This white piece here is a lighter thread that's being used to sew this onto this lace. If you can just make sure you only rip off this light thread and do that like in just little bits, like there's a little piece stuck right here. If you can just take your ripper and start just pulling these little pieces out all the way around, it's gonna take some time, but I'm telling you, it'll be better than you trying to just cut it close. Because, okay, so as you saw, it is very delicate, that thread between the lace that you wanna keep and that faux scalp that you wanna take out. You can cut it, but in order to get rid of that line of demarcation, you're gonna have to take it off, and you're gonna have to take it off, not just cut the lace, not just cut that faux scalp really close to that line where it's sewn. You need to take that line off in order for you to actually have a proper part. So when I took it off and I put powder in the part, and then I laid some baby hairs and I put a little powder up here, it really improved it a lot. It looks a lot better, because I don't have to worry about that line being there anymore. But again, this ripper is really important, and be very careful, because as I showed you in the video, there's a little white thread that's running across the front that's different than the other thread that is in the wig. You need to make sure that when you use this that you're very careful, because as I said, if you break that white thread in between those two layers and carefully, you know, pull it apart, you'll be able to retain the condition of your lace and get rid of that faux scalp. If I can find some better pictures of how to do this, but any sewing website that talks about using a sewing ripper will show you the proper technique for using a sewing ripper. And it's really important, because you want to make sure that you don't rip your lace, but you also want to get rid of that line. And the only way you're going to do that is not just cutting it close to the sewing and keeping it there, keeping that line there, but getting rid of that piece altogether. So hopefully that's going to help you when you actually do this. And again, after I cut that out, I laid it down with some spray. I used the Even spray, and I put a little powder in the front to just match everything up, besides powder in the middle, and it looks way better. Second thing I want to tell you in terms of an update of this wig, the yakky texture is still very good. It's beginning to lose its bump. And some people don't like bumps anyway, but it's beginning to lose its bump just a little bit. And the other thing is, I talked to you before about the size of this cap. This cap is very small head friendly. This is not a big head friendly cap. I have a 22 inch head. Before I came on here today, I took out the elastic band. I even took out the straps in the back. And I braided my hair down flat. Let me turn around so I can show you. I braided my hair flat. So as you can see, it is flat. And this wig is still tight. So I'm just letting you know that if you have a head that's 22 inches or larger, you're gonna have a really tight fit. Cause I mean, I can feel how tight this is. I don't have on a wig grip. I barely have on a cap. My cap is sitting like way back here, but no wig grip, and this wig is tight on my head. And like I said, I braided my hair down. So that's something else to keep in mind, because I think someone had asked me, well, if you braid your hair down on the back, maybe it won't be as tight. No. And I didn't think that was going to be the case anyway, but yeah, but I braided it down anyway, just to show you that even with it braided down flat in the back, even if you don't have any hair, and this is going to be tight. I'm just telling you, if your head is 22 and a half or larger, I would not get this wig because it's going to give you a headache. So yeah, those are the updates that I had for this wig, but I wanted you to see this result without the faux scalp. I think it's better in the front without the faux scalp. And like I said, it worked for me, but for some reason that line was just bugging me and I just felt like I needed to take it out. I have another wig coming up for you guys shortly, another Bobbi Boss wig, so we'll talk about that one later. In the meantime, if you are still interested in Carrie, I will put the information down in the description section for you. Again, I have her in a 4. She comes in a lot of other colors, the regular colors, as well as some burgundies, a blue, something called tarot. I don't even know what that is. It comes in some kind of a pink, and you know. So yeah, so go have a good time with this wig if you have a small head. And again, if you happen to get another Bobbi Boss wig and it has that faux scalp in it, the way that you cut it out is using this. You know, you can use scissors too for the, you know, for the outer part of it, but when you get really close into that line, you're gonna need to take it off with this, okay? All right, so hope that helps. Thank you so much for watching. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please hit the subscription button and the notification bell so that you don't miss any of my uploads. And as always, say, ladies, if you're going to show love to anyone today, please show it to the creator. I'm still looking good, and of course, so are you. See you next time.